Now, how many communication events are happening in every round? Well, it's order of n communication events per every round, because every processor is sending a message to another processor in every round. And therefore, the amount of communication that's happening is order of n, where n is the number of processors that are participating in this barrier. So now you can quickly see what's going to happen in the next round. In the next round, k is going to be equal to 1, and therefore, I'm going to choose, each processor is going to choose a neighbor to send a message to based on this formula that I have here. So in round 0, for instance, what we did was P0 was sending a message to a neighbor that is 1 distant from it, because k was 0. And now, in round 1, k is 1, and therefore, P0 is going to be sending a message to a neighbor that is 2 distant from it. So P0 will send to P2, and similarly P1, 2 distant from it, P3, P2, 2 distant, P4. P4, 2 distant from it, in cyclic order, is going to be P1. So it's sending a message to P1. So that's the round 1 of communication with k equal to 1, round 1 of communication, where, once again, order of n messages are being exchanged among these processors to indicate that this round is complete. Just as I said about round 0, every processor will know that this round is complete when it receives a message from its ordained neighbor. So in this case, P2 is going to expect to receive a message from P0, and it has also sent its message to P4, its ordained neighbor to which it is supposed to send a message in this round. Once it is done, P2 knows that round 1 is over and it can progress to the next round. So the independent decision is being made by each one of these processors in terms of knowing that this particular round is over and they can progress to the next round of the dissemination barrier. And just as I mentioned in the previous round, all of these communications happen in parallel. So if the interconnection network has redundant parallel paths, these parallel paths can be exploited by the dissemination barrier in order to do this communication very effectively. So in the next round, meaning round number 2, k is equal to 2, and therefore what we're going to do is every one of these processors is going to be choosing a neighbor that is 4 distant from itself. So in other words, P0 is going to send a message to its neighbor that is 4 distant, that is P4. P1 is going to send it to 4 distant, which means if you wrap it around, it's going to be P0 and so on. So this is the communication that's happening in round 2, where every processor is sending a message to its neighbor who is 4 distant, because k equal to 2, 4 distant from itself. So just sort of belaboring the point, the gossip in round 2 is over so far as P3 is concerned, when it has received a gossip message from its 4 distant neighbor, which happens to be P4, and it has also sent a message to its 4 distant neighbor, P2 in this case. At this point, every one of these processors knows that round 2 of gossip is complete. And similar to what I've been emphasizing all along, parallel communication paths in the interconnection network can be fully exploited by the dissemination barrier algorithm.